वेलकम एवरी वन. वॉट इज प्रदूषण और वॉट इज द राइट टाइम फॉर चैंटिंग मंत्रास. सो दैट इज वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट टूडे. सो एज वी ऑल नो, गुड टाइम टू मेडिटेशन इज ऑलवेज ड्यूरिंग द ब्रह्म मुहूर्त इन द मॉर्निंग. लाइक दैट फॉर एवरी अदर प्रैक्टिस, ऑल अदर स्पिरिचुअल प्रैक्टिस और एनी अदर थिंग्स, देर इज अ स्पेसिफिक टाइम फॉर इट. ओके, एंड दैट इज द टाइम यू विल रीड द मैक्सिमम बेनिफिट. इन अ सिंपल वर्ड्स, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टेल यू इज, If you want to have some nutritious food or anything, like you're looking for strength, you need to read the food when you are feeling hunger. Then only your body will mix with the hydrochloric acid and it will completely get absorbed into your body. If you keep on eating in other times, or when already you had food and you are going to have certain vitamins or any nutritious food, your body will not absorb it. Same way here, certain things, spiritual practices has to be done at a certain time, has the maximum benefit for it. So as I said, what is the right time? That is what our ancestors were doing. What they did is, they understood that moon's influence on us is very greater. It influences our mind particularly, and also our emotions. So if you know about each and every day, like based on the moon, each and every day of the moon is called as Tithi in astrology. And each and every Tithi they have documented. A lot of scripts talk about each and every Tithi. There are certain duties to be performing according to various path. People who follow Bhakti Yoga, they have a prescribed list of rituals they have to do. People who follow meditation, they have a set of practices of mindfulness. They do it on based on the moon. Like the people who are in the knowledge, they go on in search of particular knowledge on that day and they practice presence of mind. Like that for chanting, this is the one of the best time called as Pradosham. Okay. The reason I am making this video is, it is based on the yesterday's video about the eight walking or the infinity walking, where we saw our ancestors were walking in a certain pattern. It is called as Soma Sutra Pradakshinam. It is called as the way they circumambulate the temple. It's not the clockwise always. They do it like this, like a curve. I'll show it. You can see this in the video now, the way they were doing it. That's exactly they do it in the time of Pradosham. So when is that, when you have to follow it, what is the exact time and what are the types of Pradosham and what are the benefits of Pradosham? So when you look into it, so if you look at every day, assuming your sunrise is at morning 6, an approximate time I'm telling you, if it is at 6 o'clock, then the sunset will be at 6, assuming it is 12 hours, in the 1.5 hours before the sunset, that is an ideal time for doing all this chanting and other things. What happens is, when the two energy shift happens, the sun is about to set and the moonlight is going to come. So when there is a shift, or the twilight is going to start immediately after the sunset, that is from the 6 degrees, 18 degrees below the horizon. So that is when the twilight zone starts. So that is a very, what you call, a mystical time where there are certain loopholes. So there are certain ways where your daily or day-to-day known or unknown karmic impressions which you have accumulated can be offloaded. So these are the secret time doors. When these energies open, you can offload all those unwanted things. You want to forgive someone, or you have done unconsciously or unknowingly, you hurt at someone. All these emotional drains can be drained off then and there only. That is where the Pradosham window is very important. That is why if you take any Panjangam, they give a very important for that particular day. In short, it is 1.5 hours before the sunset. On that particular day. So, but you will have to calculate. It changes from city to city, town to town. You'll have to check your local time, sunrise and sunset. Exactly, it's before that. Or in a nutshell, what people say, or when you refer any internet website, they will always say 4:30 to 6 is the Pradosham time. But if you want to do it more accurately, set the sunset time, just move it 1.5 hours before and you can do it. There are multiple types of Pradoshams here, daily doing it. So like Monday, Sunday, all these days, but Saturday is considered to be very important, where it works at a very deeper conscious level, and also it works with your past life, since what you have been accumulated inside your spinal cord. That is the time when you chant, those things get evaporated or get vanished. Technically, these are the mysterious impressions imprinted in your DNA. So it just goes and nullifies all those things. The chanting has that power. A lot of researches have been done on the power of chanting, or a specific mantra, or name anything. So when you specifically allot that time, or you can surrender towards the nature, any mantras you know, when you chant, those impressions will start vanishing. You don't even need to know what happened to your past or your ancestors' curse or anything. Without knowing, it will start cleansing your body. It works at a very certain level. So this is called as daily Pradosha, Monday, Tuesday, like that they keep doing it. Then whatever is very deeper, that is your on a day-to-day, that is your ancestral part or your past life things which you have been carrying, you have to definitely do it on a tidi base. So when you're looking at tidi, means each and every day of the moon cycle, that moon day is called as tidi, the distance between sun and the moon. So it is on the Trayodasi, so that is the 13th day. If the pradosham is done, that is called as that's one of the type of pradosham. It's called tidi based pradosham that can be done. And then you also have Mahapradosham, which happens every year, and there's a specific time according to your location in your Panjangam or Indian Almanac calendar. If you look at it, it will give you a detailed discussion there. In that particular time, you will have to perform. In short, what you have to do is very simple. If you are following Bhakti Yoga, you will have to start fast that day. From morning sunrise onwards, you will have to fast all the way till the sunset. And then you go to the temple and then you circumambulate in a very specific direction as you see in the picture here. You have to circumambulate and then you come and sit and perform the puja or whatever the aratis you follow for Bhakti Yoga people. For people who follow spirituality, who is more into meditation and chanting and they believe in the energies, not on the stories and other things. So then what you can do is you can follow the 8 walking, very simple method. You can just do 8 walking that time, say 20 minutes north to south and south to north. Once you make one round, then you can sit in a place peacefully, whether facing north, northeast or the east direction. You can have Rudraksha seed in your hand and you can chant any one mantra continuously for that time till it is end of the pradoshan time. Okay, these mantras could be bija mantras. These are the mantras you personally got initiated wherever you go, whenever you attend any initiation sessions or upasanas. If you have received those mantras, that is a beautiful time to do, and there is a lot of chances you might get siddhi of that mantra very soon. So start practicing on that particular time. Because this question came to me in our community when people ask for meditation, you have a morning time. Is there any specific for chanting? Pradosham is the one of the beautiful time you can do. There's a lot of stories and mythologies and history. A lot of people have shared, and there's a lot of things. So why they have given is, it's basically they created all those things for people to give that importance on that particular time. So every day you have a bonus, like I think like an eraser time. It is the eraser time of your daily activity. So exactly before the sunset 1:30, keep pay attention to that day daily. Or simply if you are in the office or do and you can't do anything, just take 10 minutes scrap and sit and chant. Take any one mantra which you like and just chant and cleanse off the daily. Do it. So they talk a lot. Some people say you can go back in time, you can erase a lot of your past things. That doesn't matter, but it does a lot of good things. It's very important. So Pradosham is one of the important days that you will have to, every day at that particular time frame, that door which you get, keep an eye towards that time and spend some time towards chanting. So do practice this method and do share your feedback and how do you feel. And I will share a lot more details, like every month one kind of Pradosham. In a month there are 2 tidis where Pradosham Trayodasi comes. It has a very more subtle effect. It goes to a, it works at a different layer. When you do daily, the outer layer is cleansed. When you do little bit on a tidi wise, it works at an inner layer. When you work on a Maha Pradosham day, it works very deeper inside you. There's a lot of levels. We will talk about it later coming point of time based on how the response is. I'll share about each and everything. And if you also look at one more secret that what we evangelize in our group is, we always say that fasting means when you really want to get into the fasting zone of purifying your body, then you will have to work for 3 days fasting minimum. In fact, we did the first fasting challenge among our team. We all did it for almost 200 people did it together around the world for 3 days. We all lived in the fruits alone. Why I kept it on to 3 days is it starts on Ekadasi and slowly then it finishes on the Pradosham time. That's how I planned it. So we kept it like 3 days. So when you want to work at multiple energy level or a package where you want to find a window where most of the angels or the spirits or the energies you want to combine, it is best to start on Ekadasi and finish the fasting on the Pradosham time. It is like it covers 3 days, a complete package every month you can do. But otherwise, daily in this time for like 1.5 hours before the sunset, according to your location, start chanting at least 1 or 8 times. Make it as a practice to chant and cleanse off your day-to-day unconscious, known or unknown sense. It's time to forgive. Gratitude, everything happens at that time. If you do it, it is a lot more efficient. Okay, do practice this daily and do share it in our community. As I said before, we are tracking all the comments and we are seriously researching more on it, and we are also learning from you all and everyone do feel free to join our WhatsApp community. Or if you want, you can follow here. If you feel these kinds of videos worth sharing and it's benefited you, please take some time to share this and subscribe to it. And I'll meet you in another interesting video tomorrow. Bye.